Hello class 7 students, welcome everyone. So in this video we will be discussing some of the long answer type questions from the chapter winds, storms and cyclones. Okay, so this will be the last video from this chapter, and from the next video and from the next class we'll be starting a new chapter from the NCERT class 7 science book, okay, of your class. Okay, so let's begin then the long answer type questions. The first question: what is a cyclone? Where is a cyclone formed? Name any five factors which help in the development of a cyclone, and what is the center of cyclone known as? Okay, so in this question number one there exists four questions. Okay, so first question here means question number one related to question number one, the first question implies what is a cyclone, and you have to write what that a cyclone is: a huge revolving storm which is caused by very high speed winds blowing around a central area of very low air pressure in the atmosphere. Okay, it is the weather condition. Cyclone is the weather condition. It is the weather condition consisting of a system of high speed winds revolving around a central area of very low pressure. Okay, central area of very low air pressure. Okay, where is a cyclone formed? A cyclone is formed in the atmosphere over warm sea water near the equator during the hottest summer months. Okay, and the five factors which help in the development of a cyclone or which contribute to the development of a cyclone, the five factors which contribute to the development of a cyclone are: temperature, here we have written temperature, humidity, wind speed, wind direction and rotation of earth. Okay, so these five factors contribute to the development of a cyclone. What is the center of cyclone known as? The center of cyclone is known as the eye of the cyclone. Okay, eye of the cyclone, remember. Okay, so this completes your question number one. Let's move to the next question, question number two. Okay, question number two here: describe how a cyclone causes widespread destruction leading to a great loss of life and property. You know that cyclones are the greatest storms on the earth, right? And cyclones can be very, very destructive. So these cyclones cause widespread destruction and loss of life, basically in the coastal areas, in two ways. These two ways are given in the textbook also. The first one is by lifting the sea water several meters high, and the second one is by producing extremely high speed winds. Okay, so we have written this in a single paragraph only, means not in a single paragraph, in three paragraphs. Okay, we have written this answer in say two paragraphs actually. I mean, this is the first paragraph and this is the second paragraph. This first paragraph resembles the first method or the first way, that is by lifting the sea water several meters high here. And the second paragraph resembles the second way or the second method by producing extremely high speed winds. Basically, it happens in the coastal areas, right? So let's discuss the first way. By lifting the sea water several meters high. So you see that the extremely low pressure in the eye of the cyclone lifts the water surface of the sea upwards to a height of 3 to 12 meters. So this rising sea water appears like a water wall moving towards the shore. Okay, and this water wall, which is coming from the sea, rushes inland with deadly force and it causes widespread flooding of low-lying coastal areas
and therefore the fast moving flood waters brought in by a cyclone can destroy the roads and railway tracks, wash away the vehicles, it can damage houses, it can drown people and animals also, and it can damage the crops, which causing a great loss of life and property. Also, this flood, the flood which is caused by a cyclone, also reduces the fertility of the soil. Okay, this one I have not mentioned that the floods caused by cyclone also reduces the fertility of soil.
Okay, it reduces the fertility of soil
basically in the cyclone hit areas. Why? Because the fertile topsoil is washed away by flood waters. Okay, therefore it will reduce the fertility of the soil. Okay, the topsoil is for the most fertile one, right? So it will be washed away by the flood, the topsoil will be washed away by the flood, then the flood water will reduce the fertility of the soil.
Okay, let's discuss the second method then, by producing extremely high speed winds. See, the cyclones bring with them the extremely high speed winds which can cause a lot of destruction, and this tremendous force of high speed winds accompanying a cyclone can damage the trees. Okay, can topple the trees, and it can damage the electric poles also, it can damage the telephone poles also and vehicles also, it can damage the houses, it can hurl people through air, etc., etc., causing a great loss of life and property. Okay, so with this we have understood that cyclone causes widespread destruction, which leading to a great loss of life and property. Okay, you have understood this answer, question number 2. Okay, you can pause the video and you can note it down. Okay, again I am repeating it to you. Next question, let's move to the next question, and this will be the last question from this chapter. Okay, and from this today's video. So what is a thunderstorm? Explain how a thunderstorm is formed. Okay, so here is the answer, that a storm with thunder and lightning is simply called as thunderstorm. Okay, during a storm we see heavy rain, right? And we also hear a loud sound called thunder, which is coming from the clouds, and we also see bright flashes of light, that is known as what? Lightning. Okay, so a storm with thunder and lightning is simply called as thunderstorm, and a thunderstorm is accompanied by heavy rains or hail. Clear?
Now you need to explain how a thunderstorm is formed.
Okay, so this is the answer, the second paragraph. You see, thunderstorms develop in hot and humid tropical areas, basically in the regions of India. Okay, thunderstorm develop in hot and humid tropical areas like India very frequently. Why? Because the heat of tropical area warms up the air and make it rise up. Okay, and the humidity provides the water vapor for the formation of clouds. Okay, so in India thunderstorm develops very frequently. Okay,
so thunderstorms develop in hot or and humid tropical areas. The rising temperatures produce strong upward rising winds. Okay, the rising temperatures. Why rising temperatures? Because see, thunderstorm develops in hot areas, right? Hot areas, like in India. India is a hot, humid, tropical areas, right? So the heat of the tropical areas warms up the air and it will make it rise up. So the rising temperatures produce strong upward rising winds. So these winds carry water droplets upwards. Now you also know that thunderstorm develops in the humid areas also. Okay, So this humidity provides the water vapor for the formation of clouds.
So when the strong upward wind is rising, okay, these winds carry water droplets upwards.
The water droplets which is present in the atmosphere, it will be carried away by the upward rising winds.
And what happens? They will freeze, where they freeze and fall down again. During the process of water cycle, they will fall down again. So the swift movement of the falling water droplets along with the rising air create lightning and sound. The swift movement, that means there will be a friction. There will be a friction between the falling water droplets and the rising air, warm rising air, which will create lightning and sound. Okay, so this is how a thunderstorm is formed, or this is how a thunderstorm forms. Okay, no need to write is here. Okay, no need to write is here. Okay, no need to write is. So this is how a thunderstorm forms. Okay, so yes, this is the answer of question number 3. With this chapter is completed, wind, storms and cyclones. Okay, so in the next video, in the next class, we'll be starting a new chapter. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.